So, etiology of the fibroid, something you know, fibroid, okay. Anything as a scientist or as a medical student, you should know the etiology, okay. What it's caused? Etiology is not known, okay. So, etiology is not known. So, each individual myeloma is unicellular in origins. Students, no evidence that it is causative factor, but it can increase the growth. Okay, it has been implicated in the growth of the myeloma. Even progesterone is implicated in the growth of the myeloma. Myeloma may increase in size with estrogen therapy and in pregnancy and decrease after menopause. They are not detectable before puberty. Progesterone increase the mitotic activity and reduce the apoptosis and increase in size. There may be genetic predisposition. A risk factor that is increasing the risk factor, decrease the risk factor. Epidemiological risk factors increase risk age 35 to 45 years, nulliparous or low priority, black women, strong family history, obesity, Alzheimer's, diabetes, and hypertension. Decreased size, increase in priority, exercise, increase intake of green vegetables, progesterone or the contraceptives, cigarette smoking. Genetic basis responsible for 40% of the cases of fibroids. These are things we can remember, okay? Estrogens, although not probed for causing myeloma, definitely implicated in its growth. Not detected before puberty and regresses after menopause. May increase during pregnancy. Estrogen receptors are higher in concentrations. Common in fifth decade due to endometrial cycles with higher unopposed estrogens. This is also not required. Abnormal tumors are usually larger. A greater percentage of cytogenetically abnormal fibers are located submucosal. Hereditary rheumatosis and renal cell cancers. It is an autosomal dominant disease. Begin with rheumatosis of the skin and uterus plus early onset of renal carcinoma. This is classifications according to the locations. Okay. Submucous myeloma. You are able to see the picture?
Yes, sir.
Yes. You are able to see the picture? Hello?
Yes, sir, we can see it.
Yes. So this is pedunculated submucosal myeloma. Okay. This is subserous. This is pedunculated abdominal. Okay, this is intramural. This is also submucous. This is intraligamentous. This is cervical. This is pseudocervical. Okay, it is coming to the cervix and showing the vaginal as a cervical polyp. Okay, so submucous myeloma, pedunculated submucous, intramural or interstitial, subserous or subperitoneal. Pedunculated abdominal, parasitic, intraligamentary, and cervical. Diagnosis usually ultrasound, clinical diagnosis, then ultrasound, cystoscopy for submucous myeloma, and MRI. Microscopic structures, whole appearance is most important, the whole appearance. Non-striated muscle fibers arranged in bundles running in different directions. Individual cells are spindle-shaped uniform. Varying amount of connective tissues are interlaced between the muscle fibers. Pseudocapsule, this is another important point, of areolar tissue and compressed myometrium. Okay. How the pseudocapsule is formed? Pseudocapsule is of areolar tissue and compressed myometrium. Arteries are less dense than myometrium. and do not have a regular patterns of distributions, but this seems more in periphery. 1 to 2 major vessels are found at the base of the pedicle. Then come to degenerations, that is benign degenerations and malignant degenerations. Benign include atrophic degenerations, hyaline degeneration, cystic degeneration, calcific degeneration, septic degeneration, myxomatous, that is fatty degenerations, and in pregnancy usually rare degenerations. Okay, commonly occurs during pregnancy, edema and hypertrophy, impaired blood supply, aseptic degenerations and infarctions with venous thrombosis and hemorrhage. Painful but self-limiting. May result in preterm labor and rarely DIC. Malignant transformation to leiomyosarcoma occurs 0.1 to 0.5%. Okay, this comes in the MCQ questions. Symptoms of the myoma. What are the symptoms? Usually asymptomatic. Pain occurs because of vascular occlusions, necrosis and infections, torsions of the pedunculated fibroid, acute pain, myometrial contraction to expel the myoma, rare degenerations, acute pain, heaviness, fullness in the pelvic area, filling of a mass. If the tumor gets impacted in the pelvis, pressure on the nerves, back pain, radiating to the lower extremities. Dyspareunia if protruding to the vagina, just like cervical polyp, fibroid polyp. Then it may cause menorrhagia or heavy menstrual bleeding. Usually the bleeding occurs on the second to third day, and heavy menstrual bleeding occurs in case of intramural fibroid and submucosal fibroid. Submucosal fibroid usually present with heavy menstrual bleeding and intramenstrual bleeding because of the polyp that causes infections, that causes white discharge and causes intramenstrual bleeding and heavy menstrual flow. The heavy menstrual flow is due to increase the cavity, increase the cavity size, increase hypertrophy, and there is congestion, and there is dysregulation of the prostaglandins, increased surface area, that causes heavy menstrual bleeding. Then come to intramenstrual bleeding, heavy menstrual bleeding, then it may cause infertility. Usually submucous fibroid, that causes infertility, and intramenstrual fibroid, intramural fibroid more than 4 cm, that may cause infertility, that needs to be removed. Then come to the differential diagnosis. Pregnancy, you know, if it is positive and consistency will be different. Adenomyosis usually size goes more than 12 weeks and it is uniform. If you see, and you will not get whole recurrence or you will not get the pseudocapsule on gross sections. And in ultrasound, you can see rate of forest appearance, but you can see whole appearance in case of fibroid. In adenomyosis, you can see blood vessels are in central, but in fibroid, it is in periphery. Then come to the ovarian tumor. In this case, we have to differentiate between ovarian mass and the uterine mass. I think you can differentiate between ovarian mass and uterine mass. Then ectopic pregnancy, it is lateral side. Okay. EPTPP positive, endometriosis, patient has dyspareunia and that will cause dysmenorrhea more significant here, and You can get the nodules and progressive dysmenorrhea may be seen and progressive menorrhagia may be seen. Do you have mass? That is in mass, okay. Exclude other causes of uterine enlargement, that is adenomyosis, myometrial hypertrophy, congenital anomaly, and endometrial carcinoma. These are all differential diagnosis. Usually, easily diagnosed, exclude pregnancy, exclude other pelvic masses, that I talked just now. Cast something. Hello? Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir.
You want to ask something?
No, sir.
Anybody want to ask something? Okay, differential diagnosis, you have to exclude the abnormal uterine bleeding, endometrial hyperplasia, endometrial or tubal carcinoma, uterine sarcoma, ovarian carcinoma, polyps, adenomyosis, DUB, and endometriosis. Fibro staging, 0-1-2, size in centimeter less than 2, scoring 0, 2 to 5, 1, more than 5, 2. Topography, low, middle, upper, where it is situated, okay. Extensions, less than 1/3 of the myometrium, 1/3 to 2/3 of myometrium, more than 2/3. Penetrations, 0%, less than 50%, more than 50%. Lateral wall, close. Then total score you have to see. Complexity and thoracic options. This is usually for the submucous fibroid. Okay. 0 to 4 score, group 1, low complexity, hysteroscopic myomectomy. 5 to 6 score, high complexity, hysteroscopic myomectomy. Consider DNR is used. Consider two-step hysteroscopic myomectomy. First is you reduce something, you take something, after that you should take another session, okay. 7 to 9, consider alternative to go hysteroscopy technique. You can do by hysteroscopy. This is the scoring for removal of the submucous fibroid with hysteroscopy. Treatment depends on age, parity, pregnancy status, desire for premature pregnancy, general health, symptom, size, and location. Emergency measures, blood transfusions, PET RBC to correct anemia, emergency surgery indicated for infected myoma, acute torsions, intestinal obstructions, myomectomy is contraindicated during pregnancy. Myomectomy is not recommended during cesarean section. Pregnant women with previous multiple myomectomy, especially if the cavity was entered, should be delivered by cesarean sections to reduce the risk of scar rupture in labor. Be specific measures. Most cases asymptomatic, no treatment is required. Postmenopausal, no treatment. Other causes of pelvic mass must be excluded. The diagnosis must be shortened. Initial follow-up every 6 months in asymptomatic fibroid to determine the rate of the growth of the myoma. Surgery is contraindicated in pregnancy. The only indication of myomectomy in pregnancy is torsions of a pedunculated fibroid. Decrease the bleeding from the myoma except for the polypoid submucous fibroid type. That causes detachment from the uterus, so you don't do that. Preoperative to decrease the size, allow for vaginal hysterectomy. that you use that DNA RH analog. Then two for myomectomy become simple, and laparoscopy myomectomy you can use the medical therapy. C is supportive measure. Pap smear and endometrial sampling for all patients with regular bleeding before surgery. Correct hemoglobins, proprietary antibiotic, mechanical and antibiotic bowel preparations if difficult surgery is anticipated. Prophylactic heparin postoperative with scoring. Decrease bleeding from the myoma except for the polypoid submucous fibroid that I have already talked. Rizaxypin that we are not using, okay. Medical neon therapy, asupressional, we are not using, so no need to know this much. D surgical measure, evaluations for other neoplasms. Myomectomy for symptomatic patients who wish to preserve the fertility. Open myomectomy or laparoscopy myomectomy. Cystoscopy myomectomy. Myomectomy are three types. Open myomectomy, laparoscopic myomectomy, and hysteroscopic myomectomy. Then hysterectomy include abdominal hysterectomy, vaginal hysterectomy, and laparoscopic hysterectomy. Come to the GnRH agonist usually used for the medical therapy. Decrease the size of the myoma by 50% maximum. This shrinkage is achieved in 3 months of treatment. Amenorrhea or hyperestrogenic side effects occur. Osteoporosis may occur if the treatment lasts more than 6 months. It is indicated for decrease the bleeding from the myoma except for polypoid submucous type. Then come to the mefipristone. 5 to 10 milligram is tried, no loss of bone density, promising results. Aromatase inhibitor like Letrozole, 70% reductions occurred in 8 weeks, appears to be promising therapy. Marina, 3rd generation IUCD, contain progesterone, LNG 60 mg, reducing 20 mcg per day, fibroid decrease in size 6 to 12 months of use. May have variable effects on uterine myoma depending on the balance of the growth factors. Suitable for those who desire contraception. Neuro management, MRGFUS, permitted by FDA. Since 2004, MRI guidance is used to direct ultrasound to tissues to elicit coagulative necrosis via thermal ablation. Fasting overnight, shaving of the lower abdomen, pulse catheter, sonications of 20 to 4 seconds of interval with 80 to 90 seconds of cooling. Research. Lanreotide as long acting somatostatin along analog reduces growth hormone secretions 30%, depot reduced to fibroid size by 41%, targeting growth factors that are involved in the angiogenesis or fibrosis, pirfenidone, an antifibrotic agent, is under trial. Uterine artery embolizations, currently it is not recommended that patients attempt conceptions after UAE, and UAE should not be offered as an alternative therapy to patients interested in future fertility. This is high intensity focus ultrasound, the same thing, MRGFUS. The next therapy is uniprostal acetate. That is also causes shrinkage of the fibroid cells. You require the medical therapy. Sometimes you are using the progesterone and iron therapy to, we are using the progesterone to stop the bleeding, and at the same time we are using the iron to increase the hemoglobin, and we are using the GnRH analog or uniprostal acetate or mifepristone to reduce the size of the uterus. To reducing the size of the uterus, we can do the big size of the uterus to small size, and you can do by the hysterectomy. And during the myomectomy also, it will help. Sometimes the disadvantage in the myomectomy, if you reduce the size of the uterus, there will be loss of the cleavage. And sometimes the small fibroid will become invisible, and you cannot take out the some small fibroid. After that, there will be recurrence of the fibroid. Future directions, no need to go. Other promising therapeutic agents are nutritional supplements, curcumin, a dietary spice with anti-neoplastic activity, inhibited leiomyoma cellular proliferation and decreased ECM proteoglycan expressions in fiber. Green tea extract inhibited the proliferation of the leiomyoma cells in vitro. So I am not asking the questions. Recurrence rate after myomectomy. Reported myoma recurrence rate is 11.7%, 36.1%, 52.9%, and 84%, 4% at 1, 3, 5, and 8 years after laparoscopic myomectomies respectively. Recurrence rate of 23% following treatment with the open surgery and 27% following treatment of the laparoscopic surgery. Age, tumor number, and size, the presence of the pelvic disease or postoperative parity were risk factor for the recurrence. Here you can go for the FIGO classifications, okay? Zero is pedunculator intratributary, zero. You can see this one, hello? You can see FIGO classification, hello? 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 Stop
it again. Yes, sir.
You can see the FIGO classification?
Yes.
Yeah, this is the FIGO classification. That is for hysteroscopic myomectomy. This is usually the FIGO classifications, okay? So, mucosal, zero pedunculated, one, more than 50% intramural, two, more than 50%, this is less than 50%, it is more than the, but it is less than 50%, okay? Less than 50% intramural, this is more than 50% intramural. One, two, okay, this is one, this is two. Then come to three contact to contacts endometrium, 100% intramural. This is three you are able to see. Hello, you are able to see the three?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, three, four is intramural. Total intramural, okay. 5 is subserosal, more than 50% equal intramural. 6 is subserosal, less than 50% intramural or more than 50% subserosal. 7 is subserosal pedunculated, okay. 8 is other, that is cervical parasitic. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. Then hybrid leiomyomas, 2 to 5. Okay. Submucosal and subserosal, each with less than half of the diameter in the endometrial and peritoneal cavities. Okay. Respectively. That is called hybrid leiomyomas. Okay. I think this is the end of the class. You got it? Hello? What I taught today? The etiology, clinical manifestations, then differential diagnosis, then figure classifications of the submucosal fibroid, then figure classifications, medical management, and surgical management. Okay. You understood or not? Will you tell yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, this is the end of the class. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you, everybody. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Bye.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.